The first purposefully created sound, rocks banging together, for making weapons or making music. The hunting horn. But where did all this lead? Man started imitating natural sounds over 30,000 years ago. Birds, the winds, whatever they could do to enhance stories, teach their youngs, a lot of things we still do today. Soon, though, it was used for entertainment as well, with the earliest trumpets and percussion in orchestras 4,000 years ago. Starting at 1400 BC, we have examples of music, or lyrics at least, inscribed on clay tablets. Moving up a millennium, musical theater started. From the Oresti by Euripides to the frogs by Aristophanes, 800 years later, the aulos was created, an early reed instrument. There was a myth that a satyr found the aulos when Athena threw it away, saying it made her less beautiful. The satyr lost a music contest against Apollo, who used a lyre, another instrument of the time. It took another millennium before another breakthrough, that of the classification of music in De Institutione Musica by Boethius, followed 200 years later by Liber Hymnorum, which is what it sounds like, a book of hymns by Notker the Stammerer. There isn't much information for yet another 1,000 years before the 16th century, when madrigals were written down by Philippe Verdelot and Maddalena Castellana. A few decades later, William Byrd began writing suites for vocal parts in the Renaissance, sounding something like this. Moving up a half a century, we reach Baroque, with Johann Pachelbel, most known for his canon in D, which originally sounded like this. But all music progresses, so it can also be seen like this. Also around this time in the late 1600s, another tie to the classics came to light with the opera Dido and Aeneas by Henry Purcell, a Baroque opera composer. Antonio Vivaldi followed 40 years later with his well-known Four Seasons.
Around that time as well, in the early 1700s, Johann Sebastian Bach was composing Toccata and Fugue in D minor, a bit darker. Another tie to the classics was the opera Orpheus and Eurydice in 1762 by Christoph Gluck. Soon after this, in 1860, a Frenchman by the name of Edouard Léon Scott de Martinville recorded the first human voice to be replayed. I know you all think it was this guy, Thomas Edison, and he did it soon after. But there was a break of 28 years until 1888, when Edison recorded his first.
Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow, and everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go.
After de Martinville's phonautograph and Edison's phonograph, the wire recorder was invented in 1890, which could record an hour of media in a 3-inch spool of wire, because the wire was as fine as hair. John Philip Sousa came around the turn of the century, bringing marches to popularity, overcoming what we consider classical today. In 1901, Louis Armstrong was born, and Giuseppe Verdi died, the last of the traditional classical composers, marking the change to more modern music. In 1914, St. Louis Blues was published, one of the first key jazz pieces. Following this back in the recording field, in 1925, the 78 record was officially released. Just 6 years later, the 33 1/3 RPM long play record was released by Columbia Records. The following year, Nathaniel Schrilkett made the first electronic re-recording, recording over a song originally produced by Enrico Caruso. In 1935, Frank Sinatra started his singing career after winning a contest on a local radio station. 3 years after that, Pete Seeger had his first performance. Another span of 3 years later, Les Paul created the first solid-body electric guitar with Gibson. Although he started his career in 1923 near Atlantic City, New Jersey, Duke Ellington, one of the major jazz names, hit a creative peak in the early 40s with tracks such as Take the A-Train in 1941. Glenn Miller, a trombonist and big band orchestrator, formed his first band in 1937, but in 1940 he had one of his biggest hits, Pennsylvania 6-5000. In 1949, the 45 RPM record was created by RCA Victor. 6 years later, in 1955, Rock Around the Clock was known as the first rock song by Bill Haley and the Comets. 3 years later, the first cassette tapes were released by Philips. In 1959, Buddy Holly died, known commonly as The Day the Music Died, as popularized by Don McLean. In 1964, the first 8-track tapes were released.
In the same year, the British invasion began, as the Beatles brought their own version of rock to the United States. In 1967, the Doors released their self-titled album. The following year, Led Zeppelin did the same. In 1969, the Woodstock Festival brought a rebellion to music. Unfortunately, the following year, one of the performers of Woodstock, Jimi Hendrix, died. In 1976, the Eagles released Hotel California, one of their biggest hits. 2 years later, Van Halen released their first self-titled album. In 1981, MTV first aired on TV, bringing public exposure to many music videos. The following year, 1982, CDs were released, adding a new format for music distribution. In 1986, Aerosmith joined with Run DMC to re-record Walks This Way, introducing rap to the general public. In 1989, Motley Crue released Dr. Feelgood, one of the first heavy rock or metal songs. 2 years later, Nirvana released Nevermind, which was the first grunge album. 2 years later, in 1993, led to the result of the MP3 format for music electronically. Early attempts in 1979 actually resulted in text-to-speech on computers. In 1994, Kurt Cobain committed suicide and Pink Floyd had their last studio album. In 1998, Aerosmith released I Don't Want to Miss a Thing, which was the first album to debut at number one on the charts. Moving into the next millennium, in 2001, legal issues against Napster drew the line between legal and illegal music. Also that year, the MP4 format was released, which added video to the common MP3 audio formatting. In 2004, Danger Mouse released The Grey Album, which had unauthorized re-recordings of Beatles tracks. In 2004, the Mars Volta released their album on a flash drive. And that brings us to today. But where have we been? Through ancient and classical, through jazz, big band, and rock. But to think that even rock started here.